Blackstone Audio presents Cyberdeterrence and Cyberwar by Martin C. Libicki. Preface. This monograph presents the results of a fiscal year 2008 study, Defining and Implementing Cyber Command and Cyber Warfare. It discusses the use and limits of power in cyberspace, which has been likened to a medium of potential conflict, much as the air and space domains are. The study was conducted to help clarify and focus attention on the operational realities behind the phrase fly and fight in cyberspace. The basic message is simple. Cyberspace is its own medium, with its own rules. Cyber attacks, for instance, are enabled not through the generation of force, but by the exploitation of the enemy's vulnerabilities. Permanent effects are hard to produce. The medium is fraught with ambiguities about who attacked and why, about what they achieved and whether they can do so again. Something that works today may not work tomorrow. Indeed, precisely because it did work today. Thus, deterrence and warfighting tenets established in other media do not necessarily translate reliably into cyberspace. Such tenets must be rethought. This monograph is an attempt to start this rethinking. The research described in this monograph was sponsored by Lieutenant General Robert Elder, Jr., Commander 8th Air Force, 8AFCC, and Joint Functional Component Commander for Space and Global Strike, United States Strategic Command. The work was conducted within the Force Modernization and Employment Program of RAND Project Air Force. It should be of interest to the decision makers and policy researchers associated with cyber warfare, as well as to the Air Force planning community. RAND Project Air Force. RAND Project Air Force, PAF, a division of the RAND Corporation, is the U.S. Air Force's federally funded research and development center for studies and analyses. PAF provides the Air Force with independent analyses of policy alternatives affecting the development, employment, combat readiness, and support of current and future aerospace forces. Research is conducted in four programs: Force Modernization and Employment, Manpower, Personnel and Training, Resource Management, and Strategy and Doctrine. Additional information about PAF is available on our website, http://www.rand.org/PAF/. Chapter 1. Introduction. In late April 2007, Estonia moved a Russian war memorial from central Tallinn to a military cemetery, outraging its Russian-speaking population and thereby leading to 2 days of riots. While this was going on, the country's key websites, notably government and bank sites, were flooded by a distributed denial-of-service DDoS attack carried out by thousands of hijacked computers, also known as bots. Although Estonia is small, it is well-wired. Skype was launched there, and the country had accustomed itself to being able to conduct business in cyberspace. Furthermore, several hundred thousand Estonians work overseas, and their ability to wire money back is essential to feeding their families. Because some of the relevant rogue packets could be traced back to the Kremlin, many assumed the Russians launched this cyber attack. In response, Estonia closed its borders to external internet access. Very few of the bots involved were actually inside Estonia. This allowed in-country users, but not external users, to access the sites. Estonia also contracted with routing firms to add redundancy to its external internet connections. The attacks stopped after a few weeks. What effect Estonia's own efforts had in this are unclear. Russia denied responsibility, but at the same time did not welcome investigators seeking to determine what really happened. In January 2008, an Estonian of ethnic Russian descent was convicted of perpetrating at least part of the attack. Considerable evidence suggests that he had help from parts of the Russian mafia, which helped organize the hijacked computers for him. But there is still no solid evidence.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.